Well, Jen, we heard David Cates say in court today that if you asked people in Mont Vernon how they were taking all of this, they would probably just say, doing just fine, thanks. Well, this town has endured a lot, and some say, though, that today's verdict brings the first hint of closure to a very dark time.
In Mont Vernon, the guilty verdicts in the Stephen Spader murder trial are welcome news.
No matter how strong the case was, there's always that fear that somehow something could go wrong and he could go free.
Selectman John Quinlan says the town continues to recover from the senseless violence of that October night. A memorial to Kim Cates still stands at the bottom of Trow Road.
Well, this tragedy affected all of us because it's unusual, and it is such a small place. We have only 2,000 plus residents that something like this touched everybody. Even if you didn't know the Cates, it touched you.
Alexis Lumibau is one who did know the Cates family. She used to be Jamie's babysitter.
I think that she probably is the strongest person ever. She lost her mom, she witnessed it all, and she's still going to school, doing what she needs to do, and moving on with her life.
While Alexis is glad to see Spader convicted, she says she and many others think his life sentence does not go far enough.
He knew what he was doing. It should be the death penalty. He knew what he was doing. He went into her home. He had no idea who she was. There's no excuse.
And that statement was echoed by a number of people we spoke with tonight who did not want to go on camera. One man saying there is still a, quote, simmering anger here in town that Stephen Spader will be allowed to go on living while Kim Cates is gone. Reporting live in Mont Vernon, Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.